Or further enjoin and restrain from including, directing, aiding, or abetting in any manner others to take any actions described in paragraphs 1 through 3 above, and it is further ordered that this order shall apply to all reproductive health facilities in the Western District of New York, including but not limited to the following facilities: Buffalo GYN Women's Services Incorporated in Buffalo, New York, the Medical Office of Dr. Shalom Press in Amherst, New York, the Medical Office of Dr. Morris Wortman in Brighton, New York, every facility operated by Planned Parenthood of the Rochester Region, every facility operated by Planned Parenthood of Buffalo and Erie County, every facility operated by Planned Parenthood of Niagara County and Highland Hospital in Rochester, New York, and it is further ordered that at the site of a demonstration or protest at a facility covered by this order, the United States Marshal for the Western District of New York shall read aloud all the general provisions of this order and any provision of this order dealing with that particular facility. Plaintiffs or their counsel shall be responsible for notifying the marshal in a timely manner of the location of such demonstration or protest. Pursuant to 28 United States Code 1921D, the United States Marshal Service may require a deposit from plaintiffs to cover the fees and expenses associating with reading the order, and it is further ordered that this order may be enforced by a motion for criminal and or civil contempt. And it is further ordered that each organization or person found in violation of this order, in addition to any criminal contempt penalties assessed, shall be jointly and generally
shall become a fugitive until death, let no one support him. You see, that which you thought was going to set you free, an abortion, will become a ball and chain around your neck that will drag you into the depths of despond and despair and depression from which you will not be able to extricate yourself. You will find that there are not enough margaritas you can drink to make the pain go away. Not enough lines of cocaine that you can snort to make the voices stop. Not enough hours on a psychiatrist's couch to fix you. Not enough education that you could get to make the pain go away. Not enough money that you could make. Not enough fame. Not enough anything. And you will not be able to escape the fact that you killed your own child on this day. That's right. The psychiatrists can't fix you. They don't have enough hours to fix you. There are not enough psychotropic drugs to assuage your guilty conscience. And that's exactly what is happening here today. Young mom, not only are you going to give the devil your money and the body of your little baby boy or girl, but some of your own soul and spirit is going to be destroyed today. And the people in this so-called hospital are going to make money off the innocent blood of your child.
That's good, brother.
But young mom, there is a God in heaven. You might say to yourself, I am so bad. What I've done is so wicked, so wrong. I can't do half the things I know I'm supposed to do already. Every time I try not to do wrong, that's what I keep on doing. I just don't have the power to do what's right. It's in me. Eternity has been set in my soul, but I cannot escape me. The pit is so deep that nobody can fix me. Listen, there is no pit so deep that Jesus isn't deeper still. And He's calling to you today to trust Him, to place your tiny little hand in His great big hand. And He will take what you believe to be a curse and turn it into a blessing. And one day you will see that little baby boy or girl, and he or she will throw his or her arms around your neck and say, Mama, thank you so much on that July day. It was really a cold day. But thank you, Mama, that you laid your life down that I might live. Because, Mama, just as a result of where you are today in this horrible place that calls itself a hospital, it is a terrible place. And someone today, just because you're here, someone today is going to die. Mama, someone today is going to die. It's either going to be that little baby boy or girl, or you're going to die to yourself
Put your hand in Jesus' hand and lay your life down that that little baby boy or girl might live. You see, that's what mothers have done throughout the centuries. They've laid their own lives down. You see, it's not all about my rights, my body, my choice, my thing. I do what I want whenever I want. No, it's not my will, but thine be done. It's, you've been bought with a price. You are not your own. Therefore, glorify God in your body, that your body was not given to you for you, but that it would be a blessing for others. The gifts that I have been given aren't given to me for me, but to lay down for others that they might be encouraged to move further up and further into the kingdom of God. You see, this is a gospel issue. Abortion is not a political issue. It is not a woman's issue. It's a man's issue. That's right. And unfortunately, we have males that are siring children and raising none. We just act like irresponsible dogs, having sex with everything that moves, and caring less about these little fatherless children. You see, that's the problem, young mom. When you go in there, where is their father? Will he not support you? Listen, God promises that He will be a father to the fatherless. He will not fail you. Not God. But if you go through with what you're planning on doing this morning in this horrible place, and you kill that little baby boy or girl, that spiritual law of gravity is going to apply to you. It is as absolute and as certain as the law of physical gravity that applies to all people at all places at all times if you're on this earth. And that law of spiritual gravity is simply this. In Proverbs 28:17, God says that a man who is guilty of murder shall become a fugitive until death. So many mothers have tried to compensate or make up for what they did a long, long time ago in places just like this, when they killed their own little baby boy or girl and they could not escape the voice. They could not get away from their own guilty conscience. They could travel the world over, make billions of dollars, and have PhDs and DDDs and MDivs, everything, all that education could offer, and they could not overcome with what they did that day. That is because God Himself has established a spiritual law of gravity that applies to you, whether or not you agree with it, whether or not you believe in it, it applies. Just like the law of gravity, the physical law of gravity. You can climb up on top of that building, you can believe that you're a bird and you can fly, and you can begin to flap your arms and jump off that building, and you're going to find out that the law of gravity applies whether or not you agree with it. And you'll come crashing down to the ground. And so many moms who found a depression and a despond and all sorts of psychological psychoses and all sorts of demonization and hearing all sorts of voices and not able to escape the guilt that is plaguing them, that ultimately, mama, you take your own life because you could not live with the guilt, the thing that you did. So many mothers that have killed their own child have also killed themselves because they could not live with the guilt. And the people in this hospital could care less. They may smile at you, but they're making money off the blood of innocent children. Every single one of them that is involved in this place and knows what this place does has innocent blood on their hands. Every single person that works in this place on Latimer Road has the innocent blood of these children on their hands because they know what's happening. and yet are silent about it. They know what's going on here. They may say, it's not my choice. I mean, I wish they wouldn't do that. But if you're working here, that blood is on your hands. And if you call yourself a Christian and you say, I'm covered by the blood of the Lamb, the blood of the Lamb is crying out to the from the ground to Almighty God that you would say, this needs to stop here and I won't work here if that's what you're going to be doing to God's precious image bearers. Yes, this is for you that work here. That blood is on your hands. You are responsible. That is your brother. You can't say, like Cain said, am I my brother's keeper? You better believe you're your brother's keeper if you're a Christian and claim the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus said, what you have done to the least of these, my brethren, you have done it for me. And he also said, what you have not done for the least of these, my brethren, you have not done it for me. So, sir, you may never have thought about this before, but that's why God sent us here to Rochester. Yes. To be a voice for these voiceless children. And if you know that that's you, and you know that God's finger is pointing right at you in judgment of you, and he's calling you to speak for those who cannot speak for themselves, to give moms a real choice, then act on it and tell them right now. Go ahead, go right in there and tell them now that I cannot live side by side with the murder of God's precious image bearers. And that if you're going to continue to do this, I will not work here anymore. You say, boy, that's a big, tall order. But it's right and you know it. And now God is confronting you because he loves you, not because he hates you. He's here, and he's telling you the truth, and he's shining some light on the things that you do in this place, that you allow in this place by the fact that you work here. You have a responsibility to love your neighbor as yourself. Don't claim the name of God and then be a part of the murdering of his precious image bearers. Little children that have no voice and will have no choice if you do not speak up for them. So how is it that you work here? How is it? How do you assuage your guilty conscience because you know better? You do.